Hi guys, if you are 20 and you want a performance car, and this performance car must have a manual transmission, it should have good handling, what would be the best choice between the Type R and the M3? Let's say you have the necessary money, because from financial point of view there is absolutely no discussion, go for the Type R, case closed, yeah? But I'm talking, if you have the possibility, should you choose the Type R or the M3 for your first car? And I believe the answer is a little bit more difficult than I initially presumed, because both cars are very involving, very good handling. Both cars have a legacy name. Both cars are easy to drive in the end. So if you do not take a risk and deactivate all the electronics in the scenario where you say, okay, ESP, TSC remains on, then it's no issue. And I would say, from my point of view, the main differences, clutch, driving the car itself is a lot easier in the Honda, because the clutch is a little bit more heavy, you do not have the drive shaft, so you can be a little more brutal, or the car allows a little more less control with the clutch. At the BMW, if you do not clutch in and clutch out correctly in the first gear or in second gear, you will feel that you have a rear wheel drive. In the Honda, no. Regarding the gearbox, I would say it's a lot easier to drive, because each time you feel if you are in drive or not, a lot better in driving gear, a lot better than in the BMW. Here, if you make the gear change, you feel it. Regarding traction, the Honda will do very easy, especially if you are in R plus mode, lift off oversteer. This is dangerous, because if you go in a roundabout, you take gas and you accelerate while steering, your rear will go out, and pretty brutally. So I was surprised to see how easy this happens. So I wouldn't say the Honda is there with no dangers, but basically regarding traction, each time when you launch the Honda, your front will go up, typically for four-wheel drive, and you will feel that the car struggles to grip before launching. So there's no helping here. For launching, rear wheel drive a lot better. On the other side, if you compare the handling, the Honda has very good handling, no discussion. I would say they are pretty matched regarding handling now after driving so long the BMW. But where the difference is, of course, in the Honda, if you accelerate very brutally in a bend, you will get understeer. This means, although you have a limited slip differential, and this makes a huge difference, although you have this limited slip differential, the car will go to the outside, and you have to take this in consideration, because it is what it is, simply. No discussion there. In the BMW, you will simply get an oversteer. This means when you accelerate, your rear will go out, and you have to countersteer for this rear going out. So in both scenarios, you simply have to take good care what you are doing. Let me show you. Basically, it rains, it's a little bit wet, I'm in R plus mode, and I want to launch the car, not very brutally with launch control, but without hands on the steering wheel, yes? So you do not have torque steer. You do not have issues regarding the car not playing well and being dangerous. This LSD will help also here, look. You have this tendency. Maybe it's important to mention that I'm on winter tires. It's of course you have 12 degrees, so they do not grip. But this here is the worst case scenario that you can have in the Honda. While cornering or while accelerating in first gear. After first gear you do not have issues, yeah? Because let's say I'm here now in third gear, or let's do it second gear, 50. It won't put the power down as you expect, but it will go. No discussion here. Let's go over to the BMW and check the same scenarios. Well guys, the same scenario now in the BMW. You can still see the tire marks from launching the Type R. So I had a little bit of slip. The conditions now are a lot better because we have 14.5 degrees, no rain, and I'm on summer tires. This means it's perfect, because in the end you will see the differences. Worst case scenario Honda versus best case scenario BMW. Okay, so let's do the same M dynamic mode, of course, and let's do a launch without launch control normally. So the car, of course, in these conditions goes straight. I had only minimum level of correction, which is also very important in this type of start. Here the BMW is a lot safer. The BMW of course also have issues if you have tricky conditions, the road is not even, it's a little bit of rain, then of course it will go sideways while accelerating and you have to counter steer sometimes even more than in the Honda. Now let's check the second scenario, and this is the part where the BMW is a lot more dangerous, of course, because of rear wheel drive compared to the Honda. Yeah, so you are at a stoplight and you floor it, as you can see. This was with M dynamic mode, where the DSC will help you at a very big drift angle. It was a huge drift. So in the end, why is the BMW so more dangerous than the Honda? Because in such tricky scenarios, the Honda will go very linear to the outside of the road, of the bend, while the BMW will go very brutally and in a very short distance. And if you have cars that are parked on the roadside, you will hit them. So you have to be aware when you do something like that, that the BMW will be wild. Other than that, as a summary, I would say no discussion, the Honda is the better beginner's car, because clutching and use of clutch is a lot easier. In the BMW you have a drive shaft and you have this clutch delay valve. This means it will always have a mind of its own. Four-wheel drive is a lot safer than rear-wheel drive. The gearbox gets you a better feeling exactly when you have this second, when you clutch, when you get in gear versus the BMW. And I would say also the power, in the end we are talking about a lot more horsepower. Sorry guys, I got a phone call, so just get the Type R. It's the way safer car for a beginner, and that's it. See you next time, guys.